Good morning, everyone. Today I'm headed to the south along the coast. Shortly after departure, I am meeting my wingman Max with his colleague Gyro, and we are flying to the Oceanside Airport in northern San Diego County. An early morning departure would ensure we have enough time to enjoy our visit and fly back at a reasonable time. The flight south is expected to be no longer than an hour, not a big deal in itself, but there are strong winds expected in the middle portion of our route, so caution and proper planning are important. As I prepare for takeoff, the tower is still closed and there is no other traffic on a local frequency. The strong head-on breeze helps me pre-rotate the rotor rather effortlessly. Lifting off, I have enough time to admire the threatening clouds to the north. Lucky for me, I'm turning away from them. After making the turn upwind, I need to talk to Burbank Tower and ask for permission to transition to their airspace on my way to meet Max. First rays of the rising sun are peeking over the hills in stark contrast to the sleepy city below. I take a moment to marvel at the peaceful feeling. The strong winds have cleared the haze from the area and the visibility is perfect all around. Ah, here comes Max with his Calithia. This really is one slick looking gyroplane. Since this is Max's playground, he takes the lead on our way to the coast. I love this part of the day when the ground is still in the shadows, while the sun paints the tall buildings in golden colors. As we reach the LA River, we would follow it all the way to the ocean. The port itself is a great jumble of concrete, oil tanks and shipping containers. This usually bustling place is just waking up on this early Saturday morning. And here is the Queen Mary with her red smokestacks, somewhat dwarfed by the modern cruise ship. This is one of three artificial islands built around oil drills. Looking at the ocean, I'm surprised to see that many ships waiting to be offloaded. This really is one busy port. Both the Chico Ecological Reserve provides a safe habitat for over 200 species of birds. On our way along the coast, we are passing by the Huntington Beach Pier. Newport Beach and the marina have been attracting the rich and famous for generations. John Wayne's house is a featured landmark for every boat tour in the area. As I catch up to Max, I do admire the smooth lines of his aircraft. I love open cockpit flying, but there is something to be said about well-designed, fully enclosed machines as well. The body of the gyro contrasting with the blue waters of the ocean makes for poster-like images. As we go further to the south, the white beaches we're so accustomed to around Los Angeles are replaced with rugged seaside cliffs. Dana Point is the most recognizable geographical feature in the area. Approaching San Clemente, we start to climb above 2,000 feet to avoid the restricted airspace protecting the beaches of Camp Pendleton. Back in the day, as a Marine, I spent a few nights training on the sand below. Those were fun times. When we reach Del Mar, it is time to swing inland toward our destination, Oceanside Airport. The airport itself is hard to miss, just follow the river, but also be aware of opposite traffic. After checking the winds, runway 7 looks like a good option. This was one really nice flight. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Please subscribe to our channel and leave comments. Goodbye for now and hope to see you on our next adventures.